So we've had a fantastic day here at Tresham. We've had Dan from DSS Electrical in with us all day, and you've put on a masterclass for us, and one of the masterclasses was using garden lighting, is that correct?
Yes, otherwise known as landscape lighting.
That's been a joke all day, isn't it? So we've got some landscape lighting here, but we're actually doing some really clever stuff with turning it on and off, the switching mechanism. What type of switches have you shown us today?
So these are a brand called Quinetic. And they are actually kinetic switches.
Okay, so they don't work on cables?
No cables.
So they work on batteries?
No batteries.
So they work on?
Kinetic energy.
We like to call that magic. Okay, so So when I press the switch,
yes,
it creates a signal.
It does.
And where does that signal end up going to?
It creates a radio frequency signal that ends up at this wireless receiving controller here.
Okay, and where can we use those then? Where have you been using those in your working practice?
So quite recently we've been using them for retrofitting two-way switching. So if the house is finished, it's plastered, it's painted, you can retrofit this, say for example, behind a downlight.
Okay.
And then from there, you can install a switch at any point in the room.
Okay, because the switch doesn't require any cables or any batteries.
No.
Okay, that's correct. Fantastic. We've got it set up at the moment where it'll control different bits of garden lighting, and we've also got it controlling some IP68 strip lighting, also used for outside. I think it would be worth bringing the camera in, and you've shown us how easy it is to pair the different ranges of switches we've got here in different applications, and then we can see these garden lights come on and off from the switches. Is that right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Let's bring the camera in.
Perfect.
Okay then, Dan. So we've powered the receivers. Okay, can you point the receivers out for me?
These are these two here.
Okay, we've powered those receivers. At the moment, we've plugged it in. Of course, then we'd be taking a localized supply to it.
Yes.
But now we've got a series of switches in front of you that work on this kinetic energy but aren't paired to those actual receivers. Can you show us how simple it is to repair them?
So what you do to pair, you ensure you've got power to the unit itself. You press and hold the pairing button here for 3 seconds. You'll see the red light start to flash. And then after that, you just operate your switch, which then operates the light.
That seems too incredibly easy. So with that in mind then, could you do a second switch and make it two-wayed?
Yes, absolutely. So what we do, same principle again, press the button, hold for 3 seconds, and we'll pick the fob this time. Two presses, operates the light, and then just to confirm, I'll put this one down, turn it off there, turn it back on there.
Can you explain when you might want to use the fob style one? Because I really do like that fob.
So the fob we found is fantastic. Say for example, you've got a outside floodlight, and when you come home, instead of it operating via a PIR, when you pull up in your car, press this to turn the light on. Once you've got safely in your house, you can turn it off again.
And that's pretty cool, isn't it?
It is.
We have also got the LED strip. We've fed it from a different receiver, so you compare. I like the one that looks remarkably like a grid switch you've got down there. Does that fit into a grid frame?
So this, yes. Now this switch here will fit into an MK grid switch, and it's specifically designed for that itself.
Okay, so can you pair that maybe for the strip lighting for me? Okay, so that's the other receiver.
Same principle, so on the other receiver, check you've got power by pressing the pair button. You'll see the red light start to flash. Two presses, and then the LED strip comes on.
That is just incredibly easy.
Simple as that.
So Dan, would you say this is making massive improvements in the ease of installing outside garden lighting?
Yeah, absolutely. Before, the ways of switching garden lighting were quite primitive and things like that, or you had to run cables back to a suitable location, which would mean chasing out the walls in kitchens by back doors and things like that, where people could easily access the switch. This way, we can mount the receivers anywhere within the garden, and then you can operate these switches up to 10 per receiver from up to 20 metres indoor, and I believe it's over 100 metres outdoor.
That's fantastic. Thanks, Dan.
Cheers, guys.
So, Dan, thanks for that. So, again, from my learner's point of view, we've been doing one-way, two-way, two-way and intermediate switching using cables and three-core and identifying conductors.
Yes.
And you've come in and shown us the wonders of...
the wonders of kinetic switching.
Yeah, and the way that we can send a radio frequency in order to operate the lights. And in this case, we've been using garden lighting, is that correct?
Yes, landscape lighting.
Thank you very much.
We'll get there.
Yeah, we'll get there in a So again, there's some stuff. We did some stuff about series wiring in here with the learners, didn't we?
Yes.
Okay, which we're holding back at the moment. We're not actually trying to show people how to connect these up. We're actually just showing them how the switches are actually working and sending the signal to the receivers. Yes. So I think it's time to end it.
Yes.
Are you ready this time? We've had a couple of practices today.
I think we're there.
So me and Dan, we hope this video has been some help.